Last week we came here to CrossFit Southie to beast out. What we did is we did two different WODs in this specific field trip. Based on what I knew about their physical abilities, I broke them down into big dogs, dogs, and pups. And then I was one of the big dogs, and I had one of my team teachers, two of my team teachers ran with the dogs, which was the largest group. And then I had another team teacher that was with the pups. So we did a 5-minute AMRAP, and all the big dogs did the AMRAP together while the other groups, the dogs and the pups, cheered on and just kind of cheered us on. And then the next team came off, and the second we got our energy back and we thought, okay, we kneeled down in front of them doing their WOD and we just cheered them on. It was all about, all right, I've done my best, I've kicked butt, and now it's time to cheer on my friends, my community. And then we did it for the pups. And then in the second WOD, we did a mixed level where I put mixed level groups together and we did a group workout, a partner workout where it was a big dog and a pup, or a dog and a pup, or a dog and a big dog, but they had to be of different levels so that you knew that the person with whom you were working was either far more capable or for whatever reason far less capable right now, but you had to work together in order to achieve the goal and win. And the goal is to win, you know? I think a lot of people in today's world like to think with kids, let's take out the competition from their physical activity. No. Life is competitive. Life is competitive. And the reality is you're hired or you're not. You are getting the promotion or you're fired. My 6th, 7th, and 8th graders have physical education twice a week, if that. They don't have phys ed. And their phys ed for this year, there was 2 months of the year where they had chess. Chess is good for strategic building of the mind. It's not gym. We have no gym in our school, really, in essence. It's a problem. We don't have gym. They are a population that is in the city, and they are, for the most part, not going to be doing after-school sports. At the beginning of the year, I always start in the first couple days of my classroom, whether they have had me from the year before and are looping with me, or whether they are brand new, conduct 6 generic movements that I need for them to know for the school year, which is a stationary lunge, a traveling lunge, a burpee, a push-up, a hollow hold, a jumping jack, because they'll be doing those exercises throughout the year. So it might be that they are competing with me exercise, against me in terms of vocabulary, in terms of knowing something first. So they'll have competitions against Mr. D. They'll compete against each other. We do team challenges, things like that, to help encourage their like quick thinking. They know the movement. So they started to know these like generic, basic, like fundamental movements. So they're very physically engaged in my classroom when they have to go to their locker to go. If they've forgotten something in their locker at the beginning of the year, they need to drop and do 2 push-ups. By January, they need to do 4 push-ups, or they can do 10 squats. If they have sworn and use 1 of 4 or 5 basic words in my class, they have to do 40 push-ups or 200 squats. So physical engagement is really a part of my day. Amy was really, really interested in creating sort of specific workouts, specific strength-oriented stuff, and stretching, and making it very, very suitable to my age group, and also an age group, a lot of which are not physically engaged for most of their life.
I've never done anything like this before, so I knew that it had to be something simple, because there's a lot of kids, and they're kind of used to bouncing all around, but for the most part, they were well-behaved. But I knew that I had to come up with something that they could follow pretty easily, and that I could teach relatively quickly, and avoid any sort of injury. The wall balls, just trying to put in some sort of weightlifting movement, but not enough weight a weight that's appropriate for that age group. The box jumps, I knew that they could scale that down pretty easily with step-ups. Burpees, anyone can do a burpee. And they've been doing burpees in class with Mr. D, so that worked out pretty well. Mr. D also wanted, he was the one who came up with the AMRAP idea. I thought that was pretty good, 5-minute AMRAP. I don't think they could have done much more than that. And then he wanted to do a team event because he was really inspired by the team this weekend at the regionals, and he really liked that camaraderie aspect of it. So that's why we decided to do a shorter team WOD. I originally had something long planned that was completely off base, and I realized that once I actually got in here with the population, and I was able to modify it pretty quickly. So, but they seem to really have fun and get a lot from it. So,
if you want to bring stuff like this to your program, it's going to take a lot of work. Find a box near you, impassion them to inspire them to think about the good that it will do to the community, because I feel that every CrossFit to which I've gone, especially CrossFit Southie, it's very community oriented. I had a cleanup at the Hurley where we worked on recycling, worked on weeding and picking up trash, and then planting, bringing mulch down, and completely sort of restructuring the front yard of the Hurley. Five CrossFitters from here came. It was posted. Amy posted it just briefly, just posted a little post. Hey, you know, Jason Dion is going to be doing this Friday. Anybody feel like coming? Five people came. They don't have kids there. They have no reason to be there. They don't live in the neighborhood. And they came. CrossFit is community. CrossFit is, the energy of CrossFit is community. Coming in and seeing the same people every day and, oh my God, we're going to struggle through this. It is community. Like, it is all about, all right, bro, like, I'm done my workout. I'm kneeling down. I'm going to be here and I'm going to put all my energy into you doing your workout. So it's all about community.